So I know the last time that we talked, you were sort of working your way through the sort of particulars of having come away with a deal on Shark Tank. So if you can maybe give me an idea of where you guys are kind of at now in terms of the deal that was offered at the end of the show and how your company has kind of progressed since then.
Sure. So the first thing, you know, with Shark Tank, as the sharks get into working with the entrepreneurs and things like that, sometimes, you know, they want to do more. And I can't disclose details, but Lori and her team wanted to do more with us. So so it's actually for us having them really intimate with our, you know, with our team and being a bigger partner, so to speak, is fantastic. So the deal that happened on Shark Tank, we you know, changed it a little bit, and now we're, you know, she's officially an equity partner of FlexScreen, which is awesome. It's still crazy humbling and also a little surreal that Lori Greiner is one of my partners, you know, from my basement or from my garage in Plum, and now Lori Greiner is one of my partners. So it's been really exciting.
And you know, in terms of getting that partnership going and sort of leveraging that to kind of scale up your business, what has that process been like as far as, you know, being, well, I mean, maybe a better way to ask this is, how has that gone over the course of the past 6 or 7 months with, I guess, I don't really know what specific type of limitations you guys have been working with in terms of, you know, health and safety guidelines and that sort of stuff. So how has the company progressed and continued to try and grow through this Shark Tank partnership, you know, within the parameters of the COVID-19 pandemic?
So one of the things with the COVID-19 that it has been difficult because, of course, Lori can't travel here. We can't travel to them. You know, even their PR people, even for them shooting their next season of Shark Tank, everything's different than it was last year. And so, of course, it has added some limitations and also some speed bumps along the way, at least as far as that side. You know, the other thing that from the, you know, advertising and marketing, which of course is a big part of what Lori and her team bring to the table, it's tough because the world is noisy right now. So you know, that side of things is also, you know, trying to strategize about when we do things, when we start doing some pushing and advertising, you know, different shows, you know, all of those types of things that working with celebrity, again, part of what they bring into that relationship has been tough because we have to take into consideration the craziness of this pandemic, you know, the craziness of the upcoming elections, you know, everything that changes. There's just so much noise and it becomes difficult. Like, when are we going to start yelling our message that it's not going to get overshadowed by everything else that's going on? So we're managing through that, you know.
I was going to say, I mean, you know, typically I would think in the course of the year or so following, you know, something like what happened on Shark Tank, you know, like you said, you guys would be sort of trying to shout this from the mountaintop in as many places as you can. For you guys, would that typically take the form of, you know, industry conventions or those types of events that are not happening now?
Yeah, one of the things that Lori has at several big trade shows, home and garden type of trade shows, and she has a whole Shark Tank aisle that she sponsors. So she'll have all of her products there, and she'll be there, and she'll do meet and greets, and it gets attention from major retailers and things like that. Mm-hmm. And of course, that didn't happen this year, and who knows if it's going to happen next year. So again, those types of things, you know, even the, you know, Lori's the queen of QVC, you know, getting on different shows and stuff like that. It's really tough to figure out what you can do, what you can't do, what is safe to do, what is not safe to do, and then also, like I said, we're going to be doing traditional advertising as well, but we just, you know, it's a lot of money to spend on things that, again, are potentially going to get overshadowed because of, again, murder hornets and Ren and aliens. Who else knows what's left in 2020? But it has been fantastic because her, you know, she has a team that are used to working with companies like us. So she has a PR team, she has legal team, she has resources that most companies our size just don't have access to. So, and we're a phone call away with any of them, which is really awesome. Again, having Lori call me from her cell phone as she's out walking her dog is still one of those just crazy idea, you know, crazy things that happen as part of my life now. So,
great. Well, thanks very much for taking some time to talk with me a little bit about it today. I appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you.